Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Firebase Releases Deep Dive. Today, I'm going to show you the Genkit Go SDK. This month, we launched the first alpha release of the Genkit Go SDK. If you're unfamiliar with Genkit, this is Google's AI orchestration framework for building apps. Until recently, Genkit was only available to Node.js users. But with this release, Go developers will start to get some of the nice orchestration features Node developers were already able to use. These orchestration features include monitoring flow results with OpenTelemetry and trace stores, including the new AI monitoring dashboard in Firebase. Genkit also includes features for making it easier to manage your prompts. For example, you can use the .prompt library to extract your prompts into a separate file. This makes it easier to fine-tune your prompt and even configure model parameters without messing with your code. Let's hop into some code and build a really basic flow. To get started with Genkit for Go, first, install the Genkit CLI using Node.js. You can also use npx to execute the package without having to install it. The Genkit CLI also includes the Genkit DevUI, a graphical user interface that makes it easy to build, develop, test, and inspect the AI features you build with Genkit. Run Genkit init to create a new Genkit app. The CLI will then walk you through the setup process. The first thing you need to decide is which runtime environment you want to use. I want to use Go, so I'll select Go here. And then use the Google Cloud Vertex AI as my preferred model. Finally, I'll enter in my Go module name. It will load the Go package for me and then generate a sample flow when I enter yes in the CLI. If you do not want to use the Genkit CLI, you can use the go git command to install the Genkit Go package instead. Once the CLI creates a sample for me, I can test the default flow by first setting my environment variable for my project and then run npx genkit start to load the developer UI for my local project. Now that we have the developer UI running, I could try sending a sample message using the UI and get results from Vertex. The sample flow talks about creating a menu for a certain type of themed restaurant. Here, I'm trying to generate a camera themed restaurant menu. We can see that we do get some results and the Genkit flow is working as expected. The Go code for Genkit looks like the following. You make a call to Genkit's define flow function and give your flow a name. And then in the code, you specify the model you want to use and then make a generate call to that model. In my generation request, I include some properties that I want the model to adhere to, such as the temperature. The part about Genkit that I really enjoy is that out of the box, it gives you enough of a framework to run as a serverless application. But Genkit flows are really just functions that you can use anywhere, so you can include it in a larger project as a library if needed. If you want to learn more about getting started with Genkit for Go, I have linked some documentation in the description below. This is a very early release, so please, come ask questions on our GitHub repo or interact with us in our Genkit Discord chat. Additionally, we do a live stream, usually around the end of the month, each month. Come join us there as well. I am Nohe, and I cannot wait to see what you build.